Mike Moore Media.
I'm talking to Lee Mitchell, director of the Madison Mayodan Recreation Department. Lee is the man who's brought, along with his team, ice skating to town. Hey, Lee, today's the day.
Today is the day. We are kicking it off at 4 p.m. today. We're actually putting the final touches on the ice skate rink this morning. Just a few little odds and ends, but it's ready to go.
I tell you, there are lots of holiday events going on today, this weekend, Sunday. We're kind of getting into that time when people are finally getting back out and enjoying things. But nowhere else in the area can you have ice skating, but right there in Mayodan at the ballpark. This is really exciting.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. And you know what? I think it's got the towns real excited, mm-hmm. Communities all behind us. We've got some great support on our sponsors to help us out. And we cannot wait. I mean, our staff is even excited. They wanted to get on the ice last night during our training. So, it's not the biggest skate rink, but you know what? It's perfect for our small town. But it's going to be a good time. And we jumped on it last night. It's artificial ice. None of us has ever been on artificial ice, but it skates just like any other ice skate rink. It was terrific.
Yeah. Well, I think when you mentioned this way back in a couple of town council meetings, I believe you said the size of that rink is 30 by 40. Am I remembering that right?
That's correct. So it's 30 by 40. And what you'll get with that, we could put 30 skaters on it at one time.
Mm-hmm.
And, at $12, you try to keep it economical for everybody so everybody can enjoy it. And what you do is you get an hour and 45 minutes of skate time, and then we bring the next group in 15 minutes later. So on every 2 hours, we bring a new group in.
I think that's a deal there for the price.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. You know, it's just like anything else, just like our tubing and our sports and everything else. We try to make it feasible for everyone so everybody can enjoy that experience.
Yeah, okay. So ice skating begins today, Jake Atkinson Park. Give us a little bit more information because that's exciting enough, but you've got a lot of different things around that.
Yeah. Now, with the ice skating rink, we're going to have some other things going along with it. Tonight, we're going to have carriage rides. It's through a company out of, I wish I had the name in front of me, it's just DeVette Carriage Rides out of Walnut Cove.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to be coming. They've got a beautiful carriage with beautiful horses, and they're going to give you a 15-minute ride, and it's only going to be $10 per person.
Oh.
Now, you don't have to reserve it ahead of time. It's first come, first serve, and they handle all that process. We'll have an area designated for those folks so they can get lined up and get them a carriage ride. So they're going to do that tonight at our open tonight as a part of the Mayodan Holiday Christmas stroll.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're also going to come back on Sunday from 2 to 6 to continue that carriage rides.
Okay, great.
And then on top of that, we're going to have a family night every Monday, and it's going to be a theme night. It's going to be a theme thing every Monday. So it's going to be so look on our Facebook page at our rink report to get information on what they're doing each night. I know that they're going to do a s'mores night. I know they're going to do a glow party night, an arts and craft night. So it's going to be something fun for the family to do outside of just skating on Mondays.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Okay.
And then this Saturday, we're going to have a couple food trucks out for folks to buy some different types of food that's going to be brought to the area. I know we have one sweets truck and one food truck this Saturday from 11 till, I think, 4. And then we'll have Santa there next Saturday, the 11th, so you guys can get your pictures made with Santa if anybody still needs those done before the holidays.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then the other big thing is we just got Brinkley's to come out, and they're going to put out one of the big state fair concession stands that's actually going to be out on the infield right by the skate rink. So anybody that wants to get your funnel cakes, your fried Oreos, your caramelized popcorn or any of that, caramelized popcorn, they're going to have it there.
Oh my goodness! This just gets better and better.
I tell you, yeah. We're putting up the lights today. It's going to be beautiful. You'll actually be able to skate under the lights.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have Christmas music playing. There's a fire pit in the back that you can sit at. So it's going to be an all out Christmas scene back there.
Yeah, it sounds like it. Well, when you first mentioned this at one of those town meetings, not that many months ago, it seemed like a huge undertaking. But there's a lot involved in this, and you've just kind of given us a little idea. But this is wonderful to have this right there in downtown Mayodan, basically.
Yeah, and, you know, it was a lot of work. And, you know, the to thank the town folks, not only did the town financially give us support to get it started, mm-hmm. the town folks also stepped in and helped us with the construction of the site. And then Quality Site Solutions was an absolute huge help. They brought in truckloads of dirt. They helped us lay our patio. We actually had to hand lay nearly 1,300 footers to our pavers to create a patio area for this ice skate rink.
Oh my goodness! Wow.
It was all done by hand, and I think our backs are still feeling it.
Yeah. Did you get a lot of pictures of all of this through the process?
Yeah. Now, we didn't get it when we laid the patio, but fortunately, when we laid the ice skate rink and done all the construction on the signs and everything, we had Buck Shelton with Uncle Buck's World.
Oh, yeah.
He come through and done a time-lapse video, and we posted that. He's posted that on his website. We're going to post it on our website probably this week. So
oh,
I can
good.
See all the construction that went into the building that.
That's great. What are the actual skate times?
Now, our skate times during the week is going to be, we're going to start at 4 p.m. So you have 4 p.m., 6 p.m., or 8 p.m. So you have three options Monday through Friday.
Mm-hmm.
And then on Saturdays, we'll go from 10 a.m. all the way till 10 p.m. It's going to be every two-hour time slots.
Mm-hmm.
And then on Sundays, we got church right there beside us, so we want to respect their services, so we won't start till noon there. And we'll go from noon till 10 on Sundays.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like I said, they're every two-hour time slots, and what I do recommend is that they're starting to fill up fast with large groups. So I recommend you really go either call us here at the rec at 336-548-2789 or go to our website, m-mrec.org, and go ahead and reserve your spot.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a good idea, yeah. And I'm looking at one of the flyers here, Lee, and it lists all the sponsors, and this is great to have all of these merchants involved. But also see something here about birthday party rentals. So what's that about?
Now, birthday party rentals, you can, for $150, we have a shelter right next to the ice skate rink. During your time slot, that hour and 45 minutes, you will get complete access for the shelter for your party, and then you'll get up to 10 skaters to go on the ice for that $150. And if you get and your party goes over that 10, don't worry about it. As long as we have space available, you can add skaters for $10 each for every kid after that 10. That's 10 that goes along with the 150 for the party.
Oh wow, that's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we've already had three or four already reserved, and they're very excited about it. I have all winter kids too, so you're very limited on what you can do outdoors with that. So it gives something different for the kids, and they'll always remember their skating party.
Oh sure, yeah. I was just saying on my program earlier today that I think in the last 24, 36 hours, I've taken 60 names, December names for the birthday club. This is a busy month for birthdays.
Yes, it sure is.
So that would be a fun thing to do, ice skating there in Mayodan. Wonderful. Okay. Well, is there anything else we need to mention?
Well, we're rolling along with everything. Another big thing is our choir concert is next Saturday. We got refreshments starting at 10:30 with a concert starting at 11. The M&M Choir has been around since the late 70s, and they do a terrific job and run a terrific program with Faye Webster and Keith Webster. They've done this for years,
mm-hmm.
and it's just wonderful. And they've been planning this out for 2 years now. It's got canceled for 2 years, but they've practiced that whole time.
Wow.
This is going to be one of the best concerts because they've got so much practice on their belts.
Yeah. And you're right. Those are some key people there that have what a loyal bunch that is, for sure, that choir.
Oh, absolutely. So that same day, we're actually doing a stew fundraiser for the rec department. We've done our stew in the past, and with Kenneth Allen, he's our chef, and he does a terrific job.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody loves Kenneth's stew, so if we still have stew available. If anybody wants to call the rec and reserve them some stew, you can pick it up between 11 and 1 on next Saturday.
Okay, so that's the 11th. Got it.
Yep. And then that same day, we have the parade there at 1, so
mm-hmm.
Come skating, watch the parade, enjoy the choir concert as you eat your stews. Next Saturday is going to be a big undertaking for us here.
Oh, wow.
But really enjoyable to the community. So I think there's going to be a lot of stuff going on.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're exactly right. Okay. All right, some other things you need to mention?
Basketball season is getting ready to kick off. We have a handful of spots left. Believe it or not, we actually have, our numbers are extremely high right now. You know, after coming off COVID, we didn't know what to expect. We actually have over 250 kids in basketball alone.
Wow.
And that's unprecedented on years past. I mean, our numbers are way up.
Mm-hmm.
And then our cheerleaders, as big as basketball is, it might be up about 15% from years past. Our cheerleaders went from about 40 kids last season. They have 96 cheerleaders this year.
Wow, that is amazing.
Yep. And then, you know, we've got our Panics volleyball practices. They're getting ready to start their tournaments back up in January. So the athletics is going great, and that's what we've got going on right now with those. Now, the big thing with the seniors, next Friday is our breakfast club and bingo again. So anybody wants to come to that, breakfast club is free. Bingo is only $1 per card, and you're more welcome to come. All I think I do is call the rec and get signed up and come here and enjoy.
Mm-hmm. Good.
And the Rotary, you know, Rotary already sponsored that, and we're really appreciative of the Rotary and what they do for us and what they do for our breakfast club. Our numbers have grown from about 30 or 40 to where we've had up to as many as 60 come to that breakfast club now.
That's great. Wow.
Yeah. And then the final thing is our exercise classes. We made a few changes there, but I highly recommend you seeing some of our instructors. We just brought in Brittany Dobson, and she does an absolute terrific job with her new BeFit program. She's starting to get in some different clientele with folks that hadn't been in the rec before, and she's doing a terrific job. Everybody's really been complimenting her. And Jonah's been doing her class. She switched up a little bit what she's been doing. So I highly recommend you come to the rec and check out our new classes. And then we still run, we got our Zumba classes going to take a break in December, but they'll start back in January.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I think it speaks well to the Madison Mayodan Recreation Department and the programs and the instructors and all of the things that you're doing to see those increase in numbers. I think that says it right there. So thank you for making it happen, you and your folks.
Oh, absolutely. We're just all excited here. It's nothing like getting the rec back to what it was when we was a kid and seeing all these folks and filling up. You know, now we're starting to get to that point now where we're like, oh, we got to find more space. So, you know, that's the best problem to have.
That's always good. Sure. Okay. Well, we'll see you at the rink. Lee, thanks for the report. I appreciate it.
Yep. Thank you, Mike.
All right. We probably won't talk again. So have a Merry Christmas.
Same to you, Mike.
All right. Thank you, Lee. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
That's Lee Mitchell. He's director of the Madison Mayodan Recreation Department. Excited to tell you about the ice skating there at Jake Atkinson Park starting today. That goes through January 2nd, by the way, and all of the other activities, the athletics and the seniors, and just so many good things happening with M&M Rec. You get more information right there at their Facebook page. That's Madison Mayodan Recreation Center and Madison Mayodan Senior Center.